You're the lead on the lead. There are a lot of legal issues and torts and weeds, but basically for you, this comes down to one question.
One question, both cases, same question. Can the government, in giving out benefits, whether it's taxes, whether it's marriage, whether it's child custody, can the government say gay people get one set of benefits and straight people get another? Can gay people get less? Those are really the questions in both cases. And the court has never really answered that question clearly, and we should know a lot more tomorrow.
And in terms of court watching, we know that there are generally traditionally four liberal justices we assume will support same-sex marriage, three or four conservative justices who will probably oppose it. Does this, like so many other cases before it, come down to Justice Kennedy?
Anthony Kennedy is the most powerful judge and maybe the most powerful person in America because of that split you talk about. One reason why supporters of same-sex marriage are optimistic about his vote is that even though Kennedy usually sides with the conservatives, gay rights has been a subject where he has sided frequently with the liberals. He's the author of the two most important gay rights decisions at the Supreme Court. So there's a lot of optimism among gay rights supporters that they will get his vote on either or both of these cases.
And lastly, Jeff, the presence of Chief Justice Roberts' lesbian cousin, and we're not telling the viewers anything that she hasn't announced to the world. Is there any significance to her presence there tomorrow?
You know, John Roberts is going to decide this case on the merits, and I don't know how he's going to come out. But I also know about John Roberts' background. I've written about him a lot. He's from a very conservative town in a conservative part of northern Indiana, Catholic family, very serious, observant Catholics, very Republican family. I had no idea until the LA Times broke this story that he had a openly lesbian, very close cousin, but that's America today. And it is just I think, a very revealing window into how the country has changed.
All right, Jeffrey Toobin, thank you so much.